when we got this house, I really wanted a house with a basement, but didn't get one, but got an awesome garage. So there were no good walls or anything to put a home theater in, so we put this system together and just pull down the screen. The projector fits inside this custom drawer. We made this design and made this furniture, and it houses everything that we need. And then I flip on the EcoFlow to test out running. As you can see, it's 92% battery power. And I've been wanting to experiment to see how long it would last. So I wanted to hook it up to the home theater and try it out. Give you a size of the screen next to me. It's 100 inches diagonal. And if you're wondering what projector projects that big right there, it's called a VAVA, V-A-V-A. And I am extremely happy and pleased with it. The video here shot with the phone doesn't really take into account how good the actual video and display is. It can be seen in broad daylight. This is late afternoon and the sun comes in through the front at this time. But you can see how pretty decent it is with how much ambient light there is in the room. So we've been super stoked, super happy with this projector. And I'd for sure do it again. And I think they've released a newer one since we bought this one. In case you're wondering about the components that we're using, we have Polk audios for the sides, the front sides, and the center. And I upgraded this center speaker from an older speaker, and it made a huge difference because sometimes you couldn't hear the dialogue because that usually comes out of the center channel. And so once we got this new Polk audio center channel, it's been way better. We have a Yamaha receiver and just a power system for running all the power. And we're using an Apple TV for running all the Netflix, Prime, and all that stuff. And coming up, you'll see another clip where it's much darker and you can see that the picture looks a little bit better. I think the camera's trying to adjust and get everything from the light outside to the projector, so that's what's kind of screwing it up. But we've been really happy with the system because we can put it away and hide it. I didn't get a dedicated home theater with a basement since we don't have one. But this has been working out really well for us, and we're really happy. The kitchen's right behind here, and so my wife and I can watch together. She's cooking and things like that. So the drawer, you know, we custom built this and we found all the components to like lift the projector out. So that's on a separate slide from the drawer slide with the hinge that brings it up and over to the outside of the cabinet on top. And gets put away really nice and super clean, as you can see in the very beginning of the video before we pulled down the screen and stuff. There's the EcoFlow so you can kind of get the size of it. And next shot here after this, we'll show it more dark outside and you can see how much more vibrant the picture is. And I think just the phone camera doesn't really do justice when it's got other ambient light around there. So we ran it down to 7%, and then I started charging it off the solar, and this was the third day running on solar, because the solar panel that comes with it, it'll charge it and everything, but you really gotta babysit it and face it toward the sun really well in order to maximize the output. But it still takes a few days to go all the way back up to 100% from that low. But hope you guys enjoyed this, found it useful. It's really fun to run a home theater off of it. Take care.
You're awesome.
Liked it.
Woohoo!